stand for DIY because I love it.
What's up guys, welcome to my show Mad Stuff with Rob. I am Rob and I'm back with another brand new DIY. Today's DIY is super duper awesome because it revolves around something I absolutely love. Comic books and superheroes. That's right, they're on the wall, on my t-shirt and some right here in the DIYs I did previously. We have superhero shoes, pot holders and lamps. And today I'm making a comic book wallet. You heard me right. The superheroes save all your money. Like the idea? All right then, get ready because it's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it. All right, let's get started. So first we need some comic books like I have here. And then you can just scan through them and see what you like. Once you have scanned through the comic books, just pull out a few sheets. I have taken out 4 sheets because I want a sheet which is 12.5 by 15 inches big. So once I join these sheets together, I'll have a big enough sheet. And once you're arranging them, make sure all the action is happening in the middle because that will become the back of your wallet. Once that is done, we will start applying tape on it. Now you can see that comic book pages are quite glossy, but to make it durable and also slightly water resistant, I am going to apply some clear tape on it. Okay, so as you can see, I have covered the whole sheet with clear tape. Now these 4 sheets are slightly bigger than 12.5 by 15 size that I want. So I'm gonna just measure it and cut the sheet to size. All right, this is 12.5 by 15. It's ready. So now let's make a wallet. And with that, we are done and we have a comic book wallet. Look at that. Super easy and super quick. I think I should do all my DIYs like this. I really hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. If you did, then give it a thumbs up, like, share, sub. I'm just joking, guys. This is not how I make my DIY videos. Don't worry, I'll show you the whole process. The reason I did not do it on this one is because this is super busy. There's lots going on this. So I'll show you the whole process on a clean chart paper right here. So first we'll take a sheet, which is 12.5 by 15. And then we will fold it in half. Make sure you align the edges, open it. And now take one side and bring it to the middle. Align it with the center crease. And we'll do the same thing for the other side. There you go. It's almost like a door. Now we'll flip it and then we will fold it like this. Make sure you press down on all the folds so that your creases are nice and crisp. Same thing for the other side. Now we'll open it and flip it again. Now what you need to do is take the bottom and move it up and align it to where these diagonal lines are intersecting. So these corners. Now open it and you'll notice that you have a nice clean square on each of this side. Now take the tip and align it right here. Now make sure when you're making this fold, don't overlap these lines. Once you're done with that, you'll fold it, go back and press your folds again. Now what we'll do is we'll take one of the sides and we'll fold it inwards. And you see when I'm doing that, it automatically gives you a cavity here. So just press down on the cavity. We'll do the same thing on the other side. Now you need to take a currency note. Make sure it's a little above the bottom line like that. And then we will fold this. I'm just folding it gently so that I get a reference fold here. So this is our rough reference fold. Now you can fold it. And then take this big flap and fold it back. Try and align it to this line. But again, don't match it exactly. Just keep a slight gap like this. Now we need to make a pocket for our credit cards. So take one for reference like this. Again, don't align it right to the bottom. Keep it slightly up, just like that. And again, fold it. Get a rough reference fold. Do the same thing on the other side and just press down on the fold to make a nice clean crease. There you go. So this will become the pocket or cavity for your cards. Now we need to open this and turn it around completely so that the card pocket is now towards you. We'll take the corner and align it. Now, because this is a rectangle, it doesn't match completely like this one. This was a perfect square. Once you have your reference line, just fold it back like that, but not over the line, leaving a slight gap. Make sure this corner matches to this line. And we'll do the same thing on this side. Now, the easy way to do this is to flip it, fold it from the center. This way you get the exact same fold. So there you go. We have two exact same folds. Now, flip it like this and fold this. So there you go. You have two tiny triangles here for your card cavity and two big triangles here for your currency note cavity. Now we already have all our folds, so we'll just fold it back. So first, the triangle's in, then fold it inwards like this. Then take one side, shut the door. So you get this big cavity, a bigger pocket like this here, and you'll automatically get this fold on top for your card. And do the same thing on the other side, shut the door, just like that. Now fold it back, shut this flap. Now hold these pockets, open it. Now push this corner inside this big pocket or cavity that we have. But before we do that, open it like this, and this small fold that we have, you will just push it inwards and then take this whole piece and push it in. We'll do the same thing on this side. And if you have made all your folds and creases correctly, then it will just fit perfectly like this. And then just fold it down from the middle and you have a cool looking wallet. Look at that. And you can see that we have made this whole thing out of paper. There's no cutting, no sticking. Only by folding the sheet, we have made a cool looking wallet. And following the same technique, you can make a comic book wallet like I made earlier. And there you have it, a comic book wallet. And that's how you make a comic book wallet. I think it was super cool and it looked really great. And if you want your money to be safe and protected, make sure you make one. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. If you did, then give it a thumbs up, like, share, and subscribe to my channel. It's free, I keep telling you. And if you make one, click pictures and share them with me. You know how to get in touch with me. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, and right here making cool, awesome, super videos just for you guys. I'll see you in my next video. Until then, do good and be good. Peace.